Hello everybody and welcome to the program Vamos para la Universidad. Remember, this is the English course level 1. Today we have some problems. Para esta sesión, en ese momento estamos teniendo problemas con nuestra plataforma. Por eso hemos tenido que cambiar pues como de usuarios. Por aquí veo que ya se están conectando algunos estudiantes from José María Bernal de Caldas. Colorado Orozco. En estos momentos no contamos con chat en nuestra plataforma. Entonces la dinámica que vamos a hacer es que en la parte de arriba de la pantalla que ustedes tienen hay una campanita, hay una parte como de levantar la mano. Por ahí, cuando vayamos a participar, la activan para yo poder activar micrófono, ¿cierto? Entonces para esta sesión vamos a utilizar bastante micrófono porque yo no tengo chat. No tenemos chat en estos momentos. Bueno, aprovecho que se acaba de conectar la Institución Educativa Normal Superior from Amaga, Grupo B. Les estaba contando que tenemos problemas con nuestra plataforma en estos momentos. No tenemos chat. Solamente podemos interactuar a través de micrófono, ¿cierto? Entonces, lo que vamos a hacer es que ustedes tienen por ahí un botoncito que es como levantar una mano. Cuando vayamos a participar, le dan clic ahí y aquí me sale a mí una notificación y yo les activo micrófono para que podamos interactuar. Vamos a tener esta sesión así por el momento porque no tenemos forma de acceder al chat. Ok. So. To start this session, I just want to remember you that we are in the unit number 3, right? This is the week number 4, and this is the session number 1. It is very important to know that in this week we are going to finish the unit number 3. Para esta con esta sesión iniciamos nuestra semana 4, es decir que estamos muy cerca a terminar nuestra unidad 3, que es Let's Have a Party. Right. So before starting the presentation, vamos a ver si nos animamos a participar por el micrófono. I want that you share with me why are we talking about parties. Quiero que me contextualicen un poquito sobre esta unidad. ¿Por qué estamos hablando de un party? Right. ¿Fiesta de quién? ¿Por qué motivo? ¿Qué hemos hablado sobre esta unidad número 3 que está relacionado sobre las fiestas? Vamos a ver si de pronto podemos lograr que nos podamos comunicar con ustedes. Hay varias formas. Vamos a intentar, por ejemplo, con la normal Group B. Les voy a activar una función para que ustedes puedan con el mouse escribir aquí en la pantalla, ¿cierto? Ustedes con el mouse manejan esta parte, pueden mover y escribir nombres. Exactamente, ahí ya vemos que ya nos estamos escribiendo. So, hello, how are you today? Otra forma que podemos hacer, aunque okay, ahí nos estamos escribiendo. Very good, ok, that's nice. No tenemos el chat. Otra forma que podemos hacer es en esta barrita que tenemos acá. Bueno, a mí me aparece en la parte izquierda. Tenemos la opción de poner texto. Entonces seleccionamos y ahí podemos escribir también con el teclado. Intentemos a ver si les da para que escriban con el teclado para poder tener pues como una interacción en esta sesión. Es con esta función de la T. Ahí dice text. Intentemos escribir ahí por medio del teclado a ver si nos da. Si no, podemos activar micrófono para poder pues tener la interacción bien chévere en esta sesión. Aprovecho a darle la bienvenida al Institución Educativa Normal from Amaga, but the group number 1. Ok. So, so we are talking about. We are talking about, por aquí nos están escribiendo, hello. So we are talking about parties, right? Estamos hablando de fiestas. Yo quisiera que nos contaran un poquito cómo así que una fiesta. ¿Por qué estamos hablando de fiesta? ¿La fiesta de quién? ¿Cuándo es esa fiesta? ¿Dónde va a ser la fiesta? ¿Qué información tenemos sobre este, sobre esta unidad? Right? So if you want, I can activate you the microphone. Just please let me know, and I activate you the microphone. Okay. Okay, very good. We have, for example, is the best friend's party. Very good. It's a best friend party. Why party? ¿Por qué una fiesta? ¿Será que hay una persona que se va a graduar? ¿O se va a casar? Or what is happening? Maybe that person won the lottery. Se ganó la lotería y va a ser una fiesta. Okay, so it's a birthday. Very good. It's a birthday party. And do you know the name of that person? Let me know if you remember the name of the person that is going to have the party. Recuerden que si desean que les active el micrófono, levantan la manito. Allá ustedes tienen en la pantalla el icono para levantar la manito y yo les activo el micrófono y podemos hacerlo de manera oral. Ok, it's Fernanda's birthday party. Right, so we have Fernanda's birthday party. Ok. Si el grupo normal Amagá Group 1 desea participar, les activo. O para que escriban, o también les activo micrófono o cámara y micrófono para que podamos tener interacción, porque les recuerdo que tenemos problemas con la plataforma y no tenemos chat. So, we are talking about Fernanda's birthday party. Very good. Do you remember where is going to be the party? Where? In what place? Maybe in the disco? At the disco, sorry. At the park? Do you remember where? Do you remember the location? Where? Where is the party? Can you tell me? Okay, I'm going to activate you. Normal Amagá Group 1, les voy a activar también la opción para que puedan escribir con el cursor, con el mouse. Ok, let's see. Para que puedan escribir. If you want to participate. And I don't know if Colorado Orozco want to participate. I can activate you this possibility. Ok, now you are writing. Ok, hello Normal Group 1. Aquí en esta parte, en esta barrita que hay de la mano izquierda, tenemos la opción del texto. Para que ustedes seleccionen ahí y pueden, le tocan la pantalla y escriben con el teclado. Listo, entonces we are talking about Fernanda's birthday party. Very good. Okay, it's about Fernanda. It is going to be at Fernanda's house. ¿Cierto? La fiesta va a ser en la casa de Fernanda, Fernanda's house. What else? Fernanda is going to wear a pink dress. Fernanda quiere usar un vestido rosado. And we have talked also about the presents. So we have talked about presents. So what do you remember about the presents? What do you remember about the presents? Please let me know. ¿Qué regalos? What presents do you remember? Okay. We have a blue what? A blue... De los regalos. ¿Qué hablamos de los regalos? I'm going to help you with the colors. Blue... Black and black, right? So we have blue, dress. Right, very good. Black. Black what? Black, let me write. Yo les voy ayudando con la primera letra. And we have this one. Right? So, do you remember? Exactly, very good. Black shoes, very nice. And black, what else? Black what? Handbag, very good. So, black shoes and black handbag. Very nice. Okay, so now we have the context. Ya estamos contextualizados. So, let's go back to the presentation. So, I'm going to organize this. Very good. So, we have... ya tenemos el contexto de lo que hemos estado hablando. Now, we have the goals. We have the goals for this week. Right? ¿Qué vamos a hacer en esta semana? Vamos a trabajar estos aspectos. Comprender ideas generales y específicas sobre eventos significativos en textos orales y escritos. Expresar ideas sobre eventos significativos de manera oral y escrita. So, please pay attention to this image. Pay attention to this image. It's like a finger with something tied in the finger, right? Now the question is, what does this image represent? What does this image represent? The other question is, do you forget things easily? And the last is, what do you do to remember important dates? Right? So I'm going to give you 1 minute or 2 minutes to think about the questions and to prepare an answer. Vamos a intentar hacer esta participación por medio del micrófono, si cuentan con micrófono. Okay. ¿Qué representa esta imagen? What is the meaning? What does it mean? Do you forget things easily? And what do you do to remember important dates? Right, so go ahead, think about the answers. So we have in this moment Institución Educativa F. Gómez. Welcome to the session. Yo les voy informando un poquito a la Institución Educativa F. Gómez que se acaba de conectar. En este momento estamos teniendo problemas con la plataforma, por eso nos tocó cambiar pues el usuario con el que siempre entran a la sesión, y en este momento no tenemos chat. Entonces, toda participación se debe hacer o por micrófono o levantando la mano ahí en la pantalla donde ustedes tienen ahí una parte, un muñequito ahí que está como levantando la mano. Tienen que darle clic ahí y ahí me llega la notificación sabiendo que ustedes quieren participar para activarles micrófono o para activarles opciones para que escriban en la pantalla. Ok. Bueno, vamos a ver entonces. What does this image represent? ¿Por qué la gente se hace ese nudito en los dedos, en el dedo? What is the reason? Why do people do this? Right? So, who wants to participate? Maybe Normal Group B, Normal Amagá Group 1, maybe Colorado Orozco, or Institución Educativa F. Gómez. Who wants to participate? What is the reason? And the other question is, do you forget things easily? What do you do to remember important dates? Okay, maybe if you don't want to participate, I'm going to explain to you. So sometimes people do this, people like tie like something in the finger because they want to remember something. right? So when you have to do something or when you want to remember something, you just do something in your finger, so to remember, right? ¿Eso para qué lo hacen? Para recordar algo. Entonces usted tiene algo pendiente por hacer o quiere recordar algo, entonces se amarraba un, se hacía un nudito ahí en el dedo y eso le indicaba que tenía algo para hacer y con de esa manera recordaba hacer las cosas. Another question. Do you forget things easily? Do you forget things easily? In my case, I don't forget things easily. I don't forget things easily. Most of the times I remember to do the things, right? And this one. What do you do to remember important dates? ¿Qué hacemos para recordar fechas importantes? So what do you do? Let's try to participate. Let's try. I don't know. Vamos a intentar activar el micrófono a la normal Amaga Group B, Grupo B. A ver si tienen micrófono. I don't know, but let's try. Ahí les voy a activar micrófono. Vamos a ver si nos funciona. Ustedes deben activar micrófono también allá en la pantalla de ustedes. Okay, for example, I'm going to say my experience. When I have to remember important dates, I use the cell phone, right? In the cell phone, I write like an alarm. Pongo una alarma que me recuerde que tengo que hacer algo en esa fecha. Another possibility is like in the agenda to write. So you have the agenda and you write the information. Okay? Very good. No possibility to connect with normal group B. No hubo forma de conectarnos. So let's go to let's continue. Now we are going to have a listening activity. Right? We are going to have an activity to practice listening. So please pay attention. The title of the record is A Phone Message. Pay attention to the conversation because I'm going to ask you something about the conversation. Okay? So here we go. Pay attention.
Actividad introductoria. Phone message.
Instruction. Read the following conversation between Fernanda and Juan Pablo. Then listen to the phone message. There, you will find information about Fernanda's invitation to her party.
Hello, Juan Pablo. How are you doing?
Hi, Fernanda. I'm doing well. How are you?
I am very busy, but I'm really excited about my birthday party.
Super! I received my invitation yesterday. Thanks for inviting me. Did you invite Eduardo?
Oh my god! I forgot about Eduardo. I will give him a call right now.
Okay, go ahead.
This is Eduardo. I am busy. Please leave a message so I can contact you. Bye bye.
Hello, Eduardo. How are you? I hope you're okay. I have some bad news for you. I forgot to send you an invitation for my birthday party. I hope you won't get mad at me. It was just a little mistake. I hope you'll say yes to my invitation. Please say yes. You know you are a very important person to me. Call me as soon as you heard this message. Your friend, Fernanda. Hi, Juan Pablo. I left a message for him. I hope he will say yes.
He's a very cool guy. He will say yes. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Thanks for your supportive words. Bye.
Don't mention it. See you, Fernanda.
Okay. So, I'm going to play the video again, the record. Vamos a escuchar este audio otra vez para que en esta segunda oportunidad nos concentremos mucho más en escuchar lo que dicen y en tomar apuntes, okay? Y luego vamos a intentar a ver si podemos comunicarnos, compartir información por medio de en la pantalla. Listo. Okay, so here we go. Pay attention again.
Actividad introductoria. A phone message. Instruction. Read the following conversation between Fernanda and Juan Pablo. Then listen to the phone message. There, you will find information about Fernanda's invitation to her party.
Hello, Juan Pablo. How are you doing?
Hi, Fernanda. I'm doing well. How are you?
I am very busy, but I'm really excited about my birthday party.
Super! I received my invitation yesterday. Thanks for inviting me. Did you invite Eduardo?
Oh my god! I forgot about Eduardo. I will give him a call right now.
Okay, go ahead.
This is Eduardo. I am busy. Please leave a message so I can contact you. Bye-bye.
Hello, Eduardo. How are you? I hope you're okay. I have some bad news for you. I forgot to send you an invitation for my birthday party. I hope you won't get mad at me. It was just a little mistake. I hope you'll say yes to my invitation. Please say yes. You know you are a very important person to me. Call me as soon as you heard this message. Your friend, Fernanda. Hi, Juan Pablo. I left a message for him. I hope he will say yes.
He's a very cool guy. He will say yes. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Thanks for your supportive words. Bye.
Don't mention it. See you, Fernanda.
Okay. So let's try to have interaction. Vamos a intentar a ver de qué forma nos podemos comunicar por medio de en la plataforma. Vamos a ver si de pronto por el whiteboard o por el micrófono. Si tienen forma de micrófono, mucho mejor para ahorrar tiempo. Levantan la manito para yo poder activar el micrófono. Mientras tanto, les voy a activar la forma de escribir en la pantalla. A la institución educativa F. Gómez. Vamos a hacerlo con normal Amaga Group 1. A ver si podemos compartir algo en la pantalla. So, F. Gómez, ahí les activo. Ustedes escriben como con el cursor, pueden escribirlo en la pantalla aquí. Right, so, think about the situation. What is happening? A ver, estamos teniendo como dificultades para poder compartir. Activar la escritura. Okay, so what did you get from the video? ¿Qué escuchamos en el video? ¿Qué entendimos? What information? Okay, try to write. Traten de escribir aquí en esta parte de la pantalla, en ese tablerito. Try to write something about information. ¿Qué entendimos de ese audio? What is happening? Or maybe with the microphone, if you want, I can activate you the microphone. No? Okay, so let's do something. Let's watch the video again. Vamos a ver el video de nuevo, pero esta vez lo vamos a ver con el texto, para que lo leamos mientras lo escuchamos y luego intentamos compartir otra vez en la pantalla. So here we go.
Actividad introductoria. A phone message. Instruction. Read the following conversation between Fernanda and Juan Pablo. Then listen to the phone message. There, you will find information about Fernanda's invitation to her party.
Hello, Juan Pablo. How are you doing?
Hi, Fernanda. I'm doing well. How are you?
I am very busy, but I'm really excited about my birthday party.
Super! I received my invitation yesterday. Thanks for inviting me. Did you invite Eduardo?
Oh my god! I forgot about Eduardo. I will give him a call right now.
Okay, go ahead.
Hello, Eduardo. How are you? I hope you're okay. I have some bad news for you. I forgot to send you an invitation for my birthday party. I hope you won't get mad at me. It was just a little mistake. I hope you'll say yes to my invitation. Please say yes. You know you are a very important person to me. Call me as soon as you heard this message. Your friend, Fernanda. Hi, Juan Pablo. I left a message for him. I hope he will say yes.
He is a very cool guy. He will say yes. Don't worry about it.
Okay. Thanks for your supportive words. Bye.
Don't mention it. See you, Fernanda.
Okay, so I think that in this moment is we have like more ideas, right? So we are going to do something. We are going to read again, and then we do the active comprehension activities, okay? So, this is the conversation. Yo voy a ir leyendo acá y ustedes también van prestando atención cómo pronunciamos, etcétera, etcétera. Listo. Hello, Juan Pablo. How are you doing? Hi, Fernanda. I'm doing well. How are you? I am very busy, but I am really excited about my birthday party. Super. I received my invitation yesterday. Thanks for inviting me. Did you invite Eduardo? Oh my God, I forgot about Eduardo. I will give him a call right now. Okay, go ahead. So Fernanda calls, but Eduardo didn't answer. So, this is Eduardo. I am busy. Please leave a message so I can contact you. Bye bye. Hello, Eduardo. How are you? I hope you are okay. I have some bad news for you. I forgot to send you an invitation for my birthday party. I hope you won't get mad at me. It was just a little mistake. I hope you say yes to my invitation. Please say yes. You know you are a very important person to me. Call me as soon as you hear this message. Your friend, Fernanda. Now, Fernanda chat with Juan Pablo. Hi, Juan Pablo. I left a message for him. I hope he will say yes. Juan Pablo le dice, he is a very cool guy. He will say yes. Don't worry about it. Okay, thanks for your supportive words. Bye. Don't mention it. See you, Fernanda. Okay, now we have, what is Fernanda's problem? Is it a serious problem? So think about that. What is the problem that Fernanda is having in this moment? What is the problem? Is it a serious problem? Is difficult to solve or is easy? Okay, think about that. How does she solve the problem? How? So we have the problem. Maybe it's difficult to solve. Maybe it's easy. I don't know. But how? ¿Cómo? How does Fernanda solve the situation? Okay. Then we have two more questions. Like, has this happened to you? ¿Les ha pasado esto a ustedes alguna vez? Que estaban organizando algo y le pasó lo mismo que Fernanda. Think about that. And another question is, have you been in problems because you forgot something? Sometimes we can forget something, right? Unas veces podemos olvidarnos de algo, but maybe son cosas no muy importantes. But sometimes there are very important things that we forget. So, ¿alguna vez han estado en dificultades, en problemas serios, porque olvidaron algo? Like doing the homework, or like bringing important, like an important paper or something like that. For example, I remember that when I was studying, one day I take the bus and I forgot to have money with me. So I didn't have money. Cierto día me monté al bus y cuando fui a pagar, I didn't have my wallet. No tenía mi billetera, había olvidado mi billetera en casa. So it was very difficult. Fortunately, there was a friend of mine in the bus. So he lent me money and I could pay the bus. But sometimes it's difficult, right? When you forget something, it's difficult. So remember, if you want to participate, just please let me know. If not, we continue. Right? Think about the questions. So what is Fernanda's problem? That's right. Muy bien. El problema de Fernanda es que ¿qué? She forgot let me organize this. She forgot to invite Eduardo. That's the problem. It's a serious problem. It's difficult. Well, maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe it's not difficult. How does she solve the situation? So what did she do? So she called, right? Let's say over here. Vamos a colocarla aquí en esta parte. Vamos a decir que cómo solucionó ella el problema. She called Eduardo. She called Eduardo. Has this happened to you? Well, I don't know. So let's continue with the next activity. Right? So what we have to do now is that we have to complete the phone message. Tenemos que completar el mensaje que dejaron por teléfono. Right? So complete the following text according to the activity a phone message. Use the sentences in the box. So here we have the text. Tenemos el texto que tenemos que completar utilizando estas palabras. Entonces vamos a intentar a ver si podemos esta vez comunicarnos. Yo les voy a poner a estos numeritos. Número 1, number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4 and number 5. Yo les voy a activar a ustedes para que puedan escribir y ustedes van a decir, por ejemplo, si aquí va la número 1, entonces escriben el número 1 ahí. Listo. Vamos a intentarlo a ver si nos da. Ahí le activa normal Amaga grupo 1, normal group B, F Gómez. Ahí estamos tratando de activarle también a F Gómez. Vamos a ver si podemos activarlos o si no, solamente con dos. Y hacen una y después le activamos al otro. So, normal. So let's write. Aquí vemos que normal está por acá participando y por acá está tenemos la otra normal. Okay, number one. Very good. So let's try to participate the other normal. Right? Number two. Very good. Oh, sorry. Vamos a activar otra vez la normal que le perdón, les quité la participación. Bueno, ahí tenemos number 4. Vamos a mirar a ver con F Gómez a ver si nos da para activarles. Number 5, very good. And finally number 3. Okay, very good. Thank you for your participation. We are going to check. Vamos a revisar a ver cómo nos fue. vamos a ir leyendo. Hello, Eduardo. How are you? I hope you are okay. I have some bad news for you. I forgot to send you an invitation for my birthday party. I hope you won't get mad at me. It was just a little mistake. Number 4. I hope you say yes to my invitation. Please say yes. Very good. You know, you are a very important person to me. Very good. Call me as soon as you heard this message. Number 3, your friend Fernanda. Okay, very good. Congratulations, Normala Maga, Group B. Thank you for your participation. Let's see. Aquí podemos revisar. Right. And, of course, you were right. Very good. Now, we are going to continue. But before that, good job, fellows. Este fellows son sinónimos que hemos estado utilizando para hablar de amigos. Vamos a hacer aquí rápidamente la listica de sinónimos que hemos utilizado para friends. Palabras, ¿cierto?, que utilizamos para hablar de friends. We have said also like buddies, right? We have used also something like this one, right? What is the other one? Friends, buddy, dudes, this one. Guys, okay, and now we have fellows. Very good. So now we have like an actividad guiada. We have the guided activity. That is a phone invitation. So what is the objetivo, the goal of this activity? Dar información acerca de una fiesta de cumpleaños. Right? So this is the situation. You know, our friend Fernanda has a terrible memory, a very bad memory. She forgot to invite her friends Eduardo and Caterine. So we know she didn't invite Eduardo because she forgot. She forgot to invite Eduardo and Caterine to her birthday party. She has already left a message to Eduardo. Ya vimos que ella le dejó un mensaje a Eduardo. But not to Caterine or to Catherine, right? So she needs to call Catherine. So this is your activity. This is your role. Please record a phone message inviting Catherine or Catherine to Fernanda's birthday party. Remember to mention all details about the party. So the activity that you have to do is that you have to take maybe your cell phone or a computer and to record a message. Van a grabar un mensaje, así como se utiliza hoy en día en WhatsApp, que usted coge y hace un archivo de voz. So you are going to do that with your cell phone or the computer, but you are going to invite Catherine or Caterine to Fernanda's party. Ese es el objetivo. El objetivo es enviarle un mensaje a Caterine en el cual la estás invitando a la fiesta de Fernanda. ¿Por qué? Porque a Fernanda se le olvidó. Because Fernanda forgot. Right? Fernanda forgot. So, to do that, you have to do the message, to record the message, you have to mention or to include important information like the place, time and date, and other information that you consider relevant. Y luego presenta el trabajo. Entonces, ¿qué van a hacer primero? Van a hacer ahí en una hojita rápidamente el brainstorm que siempre hacemos. Bueno, ¿qué informaciones le voy a dar a Fernanda, a Caterine sobre la fiesta de Fernanda? Entonces, bueno, el lugar, primera, ¿cierto? En primer lugar. ¿Cuándo es la fiesta? ¿A qué horas empieza? ¿Qué música van a bailar? Toda esa información. All the information that you know about Fernanda's party. You can invent. Aquí podemos inventar cositas sobre esa fiesta, ¿cierto? Listo. Y luego hacen la grabación. La grabación tienen que decirle, hola Fernanda, it's me. Hello, perdón, Fernanda no, Catherine. Hello Catherine, it's me, Danilo. I want to invite you to the Fernanda's party because Fernanda forgot to send you in the invitation. The party is next week. The party is in the at the disco, whatever. ¿Cierto? Le van a enviar toda la información a Caterine sobre esa fiesta. And then you present the activity, right? So this is the actividad guiada. And in this way we can finish our session. Entonces les recuerdo un poquito sobre la actividad guiada. Recuerden que estamos en el marco, estamos hablando de la fiesta de Fernanda. Fernanda tiene muy mala memoria, se le olvidó invitar a Eduardo y a Caterine. A Eduardo, Fernanda lo llamó y como él no contestó, le dejaron un mensaje. Y a Caterine no la ha podido llamar. Y ese es el rol que tenemos, esa es nuestra tarea, ¿cierto? Ese es nuestro deber, enviarle un mensaje a Caterine invitándola a la fiesta de Fernanda. ¿Qué información vamos a incluir en el mensaje? ¿Cuándo es la fiesta? ¿En qué lugar? ¿A qué hora se empieza? Ustedes pueden incluir más cosas. Pueden hablar de la ropa, de la música que vamos a hacer, que van a bailar. De pronto la comida que van a dar. So, you have all the information. Ustedes tienen mucha información y pueden inventar cosas relacionadas a la fiesta. ¿Ok? So, I want to say thank you. Quiero agradecer a las personas que estuvieron conectadas en esta sesión, a los estudiantes, los profes, sabiendo pues que teníamos esta dificultad con la plataforma, que no nos dejaba utilizar el chat, que la interacción era un poco compleja. But anyways, we are here, right? Trying to share knowledge, to learn English, and to share with you, because I really like to share with you. A pesar de las dificultades que tuvimos con la plataforma, tuvimos una muy buena sesión. I want to say thank you to Institución Educativa F. Gómez, Normal Group B, Normal Amagá Group 1, and Student Colorado Orozco, that I think is from José María Bernal School in Caldas, right? So, thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much. Remember, try to do the actividad guiada. Because in that way we can learn English, we can practice, and we are going to enjoy this session. Y prepárense porque en nuestra siguiente sesión tendremos la actividad de creación. Recuerden que final de cada unidad tenemos una actividad de creación. So, thank you very much. See you in the next session. Bye bye. Listo, Aníbal.